any physical deformity can have a very bad impact on the psychology of a person. Many people lose their self-confidence, cut down on their social interactions, and try to hide their insecurity. Hi, I'm Dr. Dushyant Kalwa. I'm a consultant plastic surgeon at Inform Cosmetic Surgery, Hyderabad. Today, I'm going to discuss a very common problem experienced by males, that is gynecomastia. Gynecomastia is a benign condition wherein there is enlargement of breast tissue in a male. This condition is so common that it is present in 30% of the population over male population over their lifetime. Males of all age group can be affected by this condition. However, this condition is most commonly seen in either ends of the age, that is in adolescents and in old age. This condition occurs due to imbalance in the two hormones that is present in a typical male, the testosterone and the estrogens. When this ratio of testosterone and estrogen goes above the normal, then gynecomastia can occur. Many times, patients are not sure whether they have gynecomastia or not, or whether they have to approach a doctor for a treatment or not, or whether to which doctor to go to. So let me start by telling you common signs and symptoms of gynecomastia, which are obviously enlargement of breast tissue in a male, enlarged nipples, puffy nipples, sensitivity or pain in the nipples or the chest, nipple discharge, asymmetry in the chest, or frankly sagging of the breast tissue in a male. Depending on the severity, gynecomastia has been classified from grade 1 to 4. Grade 1 is very small glandular enlargement right beneath the nipple. Grade 2 is a moderate enlargement of the gland. Grade 3 is a moderate enlargement with a little bit of excessive skin. And grade 4 is a very marked enlargement of the gland, very similar to that of a female. Apart from the common causes of gynecomastia, which is hormonal imbalance, there are a few less common causes of gynecomastia, which are drug intake, or intake of medications, drug abuse, or frankly some health conditions. For example, some medications are anti-androgens, anabolic steroids, anti-HIV medications, antidepressants, anti-anxiety drugs, anti-cancer drugs, etc. And certain types of drug abuse can also lead to gynecomastia, which is the most common one of which is alcohol abuse, amphetamine abuse, marijuana, and heroin, etc. Some health conditions which can cause gynecomastia are Klinefelter syndrome, hormonally active tumors, hyperthyroidism, hypertension, and kidney failure, liver failure, etc. The next question is when to treat a gynecomastia and how to treat a gynecomastia. So the only definitive treatment for gynecomastia is always a surgery. But before thinking of surgery, especially in pubertal gynecomastia, it is better to wait for one whole year before thinking of surgery. And as for gynecomastia caused by drug intake, drug abuse, or any other health conditions, it is better to pre-treat these conditions before thinking of gynecomastia surgery. Before we go any further, please subscribe to our YouTube channel and don't forget to press the bell icon to get latest updates. Now, let us understand how the gynecomastia surgery is performed. The aim of a gynecomastia surgery is to remove the excess gland and excess fat surrounding the gland and restore the chest to a more masculine form. Having said that, depending on the stage of gynecomastia or the grade of gynecomastia, there are a few variations in the surgery that can be performed. However, in this video, I will be describing to you the most commonly performed method of gynecomastia procedure. Once it is decided that a patient needs gynecomastia surgery, the very first step that we go about is to assess whether the patient is healthy enough to undertake the procedure. Once that is out of the way, then we decide what kind of surgery is he suitable for in terms of anesthesia? Is it under local? Is it under general? Generally speaking, grade 1 and 2 gynecomastia are small and can be easily done under a local anesthetic. Whereas when it comes to grade 3 and 4, the gynecomastia is of a large enough size to mandate higher levels of anesthesia, such as a short general anesthesia or a general anesthesia. However, every one of these surgeries is performed under a daycare setup. That is, the patient is admitted in the morning and sent home by evening. As an example, for descriptive purpose, I am going to describe a typical gynecomastia surgery in a grade 2 or 3 gynecomastia. The first step after administration of anesthesia is liposuction. That is, suction of the fat around the glandular tissue, that is on the chest wall. This can be performed through an incision, a very tiny 1 cm incision, either in the axilla or in the lower half of the breast or via the areolar border. Any of these incisions are fine depending on the patient choice. Once the liposuction is performed, then treatment is directed towards the glandular tissue, which is excised physically via an incision at the border of the areola. This helps us in retrieving the entire gland either as a whole or in a piecemeal fashion. Once this is done, the area is checked for any bleeding or residual tissue. Once that is out of the way, then closure is commenced. 2 or 3 sutures are necessary to close the periareolar tissue, and a single suture is necessary to close the access incision for the liposuction. Once all the closure is done, then compression dressings are applied to the chest wall. This compression helps in preventing hematomas or seromas, that is collection of fluid between the skin and the muscle, where previously the gland and fatty tissue was residing and which has been excised now. This helps in prevention of these complications, as well as it helps the skin to heal faster and contract much better. Once the surgery is completed in this fashion, then recovery from anesthesia takes place, if it is short general or general anesthesia, or if it is in a case where it is done under completely under local anesthesia, there is no recovery period. The patient takes rest for about 3 to 4 hours post surgery in the recovery room. After that, he will be fit to walk out of the surgical center. Who is an ideal candidate for gynecomastia surgery? An ideal candidate is, of course, someone who is suffering from gynecomastia, but more importantly, someone who has gynecomastia has been suffering from the psychological ill effects of having a gynecomastia. He is an ideal candidate. Moreover, the person should not be on any medications or should not be a drug user or an alcoholic or a smoker, and who has no health conditions that can hamper a smooth recovery process. Such a person is an ideal candidate for gynecomastia surgery. I have been receiving many queries regarding gynecomastia and I have tried to answer them in this video. However, if you have any more queries, please feel free to put your questions in the comment box. Now that you have understood what goes on in a gynecomastia surgery, I am going to list out a few benefits of gynecomastia surgery now. The first and the most important benefit is the boost to the self-confidence. As I have previously mentioned, gynecomastia can be a big hit on a person's self-confidence and morale. It can affect with such severity that many men, and especially adolescents, go into depression, go into withdrawal from social activity, stay away from sports, suffer from intense peer pressure. Overall, it has got a deleterious effect on multiple phases of a man's psychology. Hence, a single surgery, that is reduction of gynecomastia or reduction of male breast, can address all these issues in one go. The second advantage is getting a more masculine figure. Yearning for a masculine figure has always been common among young men. However, in men who suffer from gynecomastia, in spite of doing all the right activities like going to gym, following the right dietary advice, they still do not get that shape. And gynecomastia surgery can make that possible, getting that masculine figure back. The third advantage from a gynecomastia surgery is ease of doing physical activity or exercise. Having an excessive breast tissue can be really difficult while performing an exercise or a physical activity such as running or jumping or any other sporting activity. This is one of the main reasons teenagers who are suffering from gynecomastia stay away from sports, which also compounds their problem and adds obesity to their problems. So this surgery, which is male breast reduction, can completely erase the problem in one go. The fourth benefit is improved posture. Believe it or not, I have seen young men and young children who are suffering from gynecomastia with a very stooped and bent over posture, just like an old man. This occurs due to their insecure feeling and due to their want to hide their physical appearance from others. And this can lead to a permanent disability and permanent bent posture in such people. And gynecomastia surgery can help them get rid of this breast tissue and improve their posture as well. So benefit number 5 is results. As you know, in most of the surgical procedures, there is minimal or no assurance for results that can be given. However, in this particular surgery, wherein the gland and its surrounding fatty tissue is completely removed, patient can be assured of really, really good results. That is one of the biggest advantages of this particular procedure. So before you decide to undergo male breast reduction surgery or gynecomastia surgery, there are certain preoperative measures that you should take. First and foremost is, please consult a certified plastic surgeon who is experienced enough in this field. The second is, please discuss all your health conditions, the current intake of your medications or any other issues that you may or may not be having with or without regard to gynecomastia. Then come the laboratory tests, which will be prescribed to you by your surgeon. Once all these things are out of the way, then the actual preparation for surgery starts. Ideally, you should not be smoking at least 3 weeks prior to surgery. There should be no alcohol intake at least 1 week prior to surgery. You should come fasting on the day of the surgery, and so on and so forth. And if you are on any medications like blood thinners or vitamin E or any herbal medications, please stop them at least a couple of days prior to your surgery. So in brief, these are the preoperative precautions that you should be taking before going to surgery. Let me list out postoperative precautions that one should be taking following a gynecomastia surgery. So broadly, it can be categorized into hydration, diet, and rest. You should be very well hydrated following any procedure, gynecomastia or any other surgery as well. You should be taking at least 4 to 5 liters of water a day. That will help the tissues maintain their homeostasis and heal faster. Then diet. There is no special diet restrictions that are given following a gynecomastia surgery. However, it is very important that you take a balanced diet in the immediate as well as the late postoperative period. So when it comes to rest, there are specific do's and don'ts that should be followed, which will be given to you by your surgeon. For example, you are not supposed to work your chest muscles or your arm muscles. That is, you cannot lift heavy weights, you cannot stretch, your shoulders, you cannot stretch your arms for a period of a week at least. This gives the skin over the chest adequate time to heal well, following which you can slowly and gradually resume strenuous activities like lifting weights or going to the gym or going for a swim. All in all, a period of mild restricted activity will last for about 3 weeks, following which you are free to do any activity. Hope you liked the information given in this video. If you liked it, please share it with your family and friends.